Hello everyone, welcome to Audacity Academy YouTube channel. We all are familiar with the word current. It simply means flow from one point to another. Whereas we all know the water current, which is flow of water. Similarly, flow of electrons is called as electric current. In this video, we are going to learn about free electrons, current flowing through conductor. In the absence of potential difference, these electrons are not bounded to any atom. They are free to roam inside a conductor. They can move from one point inside a conductor to some other point. So from where do we get these free electrons? Are these electrons already present inside a conductor? Yes, these electrons are present inside a conductor. In order to understand this free electron, we need to look to its definition first. In a metallic conductor, the outermost electrons are weakly bound to the nucleus of an atom. On gaining sufficient energy, it frees itself from the outer valence orbit. These are called as free electrons. These electrons are negatively charged and act as a negative charge carrier from one point to another. You can clearly see the structure of an atom in which the electron in the valence shell gains sufficient energy to come out of the orbit and create a vacancy inside that orbit. Or we can simply say a vacancy is created in the valence shell. Now let us understand how current flows through a conductor. In figure A, it is clearly seen that when potential difference is not applied to a conductor, the electrons show random motion. These electrons are not under any influence of external field. But if we observe figure B, we apply a potential difference using a DC voltage source, that is battery. As soon as the battery gets connected in the circuit, the random motion of electron is not observed. We observe the drift in the direction of motion of electrons in a particular direction. Now this flow of electron is from negative terminal, that is from lower potential of the battery, to the highest potential or positive terminal of a battery. This motion is due to applied potential difference. Since the positive terminal is on the higher side and the negative terminal is on the lower side. We already know that like water, which flows from higher potential or higher point to lower point, similarly the conventional flow of electric current is from higher to lower potential. We represent the conventional flow of current by arrows from positive to negative of the battery, but actual flow of electron is from negative terminal to positive terminal of a battery, which you can clearly see in the diagram. Now we are going to see what is electric current. As described earlier, the flow of electrons is called as electric current. An electric current is flow of electrons through a conductor. A current I is charge passing through the conductor in time t. Mathematically, it can be written as current capital I equals to capital Q upon small t, where capital Q is charge on electron and t is time taken by the electron to move from one point to another when potential difference is applied. The SI unit of charge is coulomb, whose symbol is capital C, and current is ampere, which is capital A. The charge on an electron is given by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So this was there in this video. Thank you.